Over the past 3 years, Ranger School has had a 60% fail rate. And majority of these failures come from the first 4 days of Ranger School being RAP week, or the Ranger assessment phase. Things like the PT test, land nav, 12-mile foot march. This is the phase before you actually move into patrols where you're getting tested on your physical abilities and how well you prepared for Ranger School itself. How ready you are to begin.
Light a match, let it go. The fire catch, explode. Blow your mind one more time. Hurricane running through my veins. I'm buck wild.
So this is my first experience, day one of Ranger School. I feel like this story just like sets the tone. I've told it before. So I get to the school, we're doing like layouts and inspections of all of our gear. I have to go to the bathroom. And at this point of the day, I've consumed so many Cerasports, which are like hydration salts, that the instructors are just making us drink. I'm just downing this stuff. So I ask if I can go to the bathroom while we're in formation, standing there for hours. I wasn't allowed to. So I just pissed myself. Day one, within like the first 3 hours of being in Ranger School, pee all over my pants, all over. Blame it on my selective hearing or my lack of attention to detail, but for some reason and somehow, I missed out on a very crucial and important step prior to leaving. The N-line bowline. I felt like an absolute idiot showing up for Ranger School not knowing what this knot was. I don't know how I went through all of Iabolic not figuring it out. Because when you get there, you're expected to tie all your stuff down in this specific knot. And it's one of those knots you tie so many times when you're there, you will never ever forget it. It's quite simple. Loop. Swoop. You have the Arby's hat here. You go through the Arby's hat. You bite down on it. End line, bowline. Learn this knot. Now, while wrap week is pretty short, 4 days, it's super busy. So there's like five main events. You have one, PT test, which is the main killer. Well, not actually killer. It doesn't kill people, but it eliminates the most people in Ranger School, which is the highest attrition rate. You have the confidence water survival course. You have land nav, 12-mile ruck march, and you have Malvesti obstacle course, which sucks. It's just a smoke fest. So even though there's not too much going on, relatively, you're just getting smoked this entire time. And you're not really sleeping either.
The first part of RAP week is the Ranger PT test, which, like I said, has the largest attrition rate. You're required to do 49 push-ups, 59 sit-ups, a 5-mile run in 40 minutes or less, and after all that, 6 mandatory strict chin-ups.
In all honesty, the Ranger PT test is not that bad. It's not difficult. You know the answers to the test prior to leaving. You know you have to do a certain amount of push-ups, sit-ups, run your 5-mile time within a certain time limit, and do your chin-ups. And this is probably the freshest you're gonna be throughout the entire school. It's the first thing you do when you get tested on. But the form has to be perfect or you get called out by the Ranger instructors and you won't pass. And that's why so many people fail this event, fail the school, and have to start over. So master your form on each exercise. Make sure you can do more than the minimums. Be able to run your 5 mile under 35 minutes and you'll be fine to move on to the next event. What am I going to Italy for?
Rome or...
Yeah, we're going to Venice, and then we're going to Florence. What would you say the worst part of RAP week was, in your opinion?
I would say the night before the 12-miler. I remember we had the 12-miler early in the morning so we could get ahead of the heat wave, and we were kept up doing lunges around the CTA, and we just got the dog crap smoked out of us. And that was the first time I was going into a 12-miler where I was already to muscle, well, I wouldn't say muscle failure, but it kind of shook my confidence that I would complete the 12-miler to time, even though I've done it so many times before.
What are you doing calling, bro?
Danny P, what's up?
Not much, man. Just got out of a meeting.
That sounds like shit.
So I remember being done with the RPFT and thinking to myself, you know, oh, I did it, you know. know, that's the hard part. The hard part was, you know, these push-ups and sit-ups and 5-mile run and 6 pull-ups. Like, you know, I've been training for weeks, and there I did it, you know. And that was just the beginning. Like, they started smoking us during breakfast. They're jumping on tables, screaming at us at breakfast. And then as soon as we get out to the pit, you know, they're yelling at us, telling us that we got to drop all our crap in 30 seconds. Of course, we don't finish in time, so they start smoking us for not making our pit time. And then, like that very first day of being, like, that sense of, like, yeah, I did it, RPFT, I'm in Ranger School, I did the basic requirements to get into the school. Like, that was, like, this uplifting moment, and then they just crush you.
I vividly remember doing body squats for about 3 hours, bear-hugging my ruck in front of me the night before the ruck march. So the other physical test is a 12-mile ruck with 35 pounds, a weapon, plus water. And you have 3 hours to complete this. Typically, I can do this in about 2 hours 25 minutes. But after being smoked for a few days leading up to it, I ended up being right around the 3-hour limit. So that plus land nav are just two things that are going to further break you down as you're getting smoked the deeper you get into rap week. So one of the things you need to be comfortable with in rap week is heights, because there's like a water confidence survival course. I think it goes up to like 35 meters, the farthest you have to jump or slide down. So we're at Barton Springs right now in Austin, and we're about to go cliff jumping. This is like the second time we've been here in the past week and a half.
And just go right in front here?
No, jump from
jump
up here
this way.
Through the plants.
Wait, right in front of you, this is the deepest part.
Oh, okay. All right, wait, I need to like bend my legs for this shit?
Just like as you land, just crunch a little bit. Combat water survival test, which is essentially testing your heights and your fear of water. There's three things. There's a long walk, the slide for life, the equipment drop. The long walk, you're walking essentially a 70-foot balance beam. The slide for life, you're 75 feet high, going 150 meters down a rope, which is sweet. And the equipment drop is essentially a 15-meter swim. So if you can swim, you're fine. I think one of the things I'll always remember from Rap Week, probably the worst experience, and I was talking to Dan on the phone today about this one, is coming back from water confidence survival. We had to carry extra uniform, extra boots, all in like this bag, and we ran like 3 miles to and from. Running two wasn't that bad. Running back, soaking wet, most miserable thing ever. Everyone's falling out. So I'll see you guys in the next one, which is Darby Face.